Good morning, kids. Welcome to Miss Linda's Sweet Shop. Today, we're going to make a hot fudge sundae. Yummy! I tell you, in the summertime, I love to go to the ice cream store and get myself an ice cream sundae. One thing about a sundae, you have to build it. It's not just ice cream, but it's ice cream, and then you put on the hot chocolate. Ooh, and this chocolate is warm. You put on the hot chocolate, then we add some more ice cream. That's right. It's my favorite dessert, especially in the summertime when it's warm. So let's get our other scoop, another scoop. And what do we need? Some more hot chocolate. Yummy. But you know, again, you have to build it. It takes some more ingredients. So now what do we need? I think we need some Cool Whip. Top it off. There we go. Yummy. Now we're not done yet. Let's see. We need some sprinkles. Yum. This just makes it pretty, adds a little bit more sweet, and to finish it off, we need a cherry on top. And now we have a hot fudge sundae. You know, it took some different ingredients, and it took some building to get to this beautiful hot fudge sundae. And this month, we are telling a story from the Bible. And remember, when it's from the Bible, it's God's word, it's true. And this is a story that was told about a man named Joseph. But when the story begins, he's actually a teenager. And his life takes some twists and turns, some building upon each other before it gets to the sweet part. Because it takes some time to get there. And so just like we are building our sundae so that we can eat that sweet treat, sometimes our life takes some twists and turns and some ups and downs before we recognize, wow, God had such a sweet plan for us. And so we're going to learn about the plan that God had for Joseph. But we're also going to learn this month that God has a plan for you. That's right. He has a plan for all of us. So remember that all month long. I want you to really get that in your mind and in your heart that God has a plan for you. So our key question this month is, who has a plan for me? And the answer, God has a plan for me. I want us to say that again, and let's really think about it. Who has a plan for me? God has a plan for me. That's right. God has had a plan for me, for you, from the time that you were born. And our scripture this month says, "For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord." Jeremiah 29:11. Let's say that again. You ready? For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. Jeremiah 29:11. Our story is all about how God has a plan for our lives. And so we are talking about a young man named Joseph. But when the story is told in the Bible, Joseph is a teenager. He's 17 years old, and he has lots of brothers. And when I say a lot, I mean a lot. He has 11 brothers. 11. Let's count to 11. Can you join me? You ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yes,
lot of brothers. Man, a lot of names to remember. But I tell you, Joseph's family, they didn't always get along very well. They had some trouble. You know, Joseph was very special to his father. And he was one of the youngest. He was the second to the youngest of the sons. And Joseph's father one day gave him a pretty coat, kind of like this. Lots of colors. He could put it around him. He could wear his coat. And when Joseph wore his coat, it reminded him just how much his dad loved him. But it also reminded the brothers just how much Dad loved Joseph. And it made them jealous. I mean, really, really mad. Matter of fact, they were so mad, they didn't want anything to do with Joseph. Well, one day, Joseph was sent to go check on his brothers. They were out working in the field, looking at the sheep, guarding the sheep, keeping them safe. And here comes Joseph, coming to see what they were doing. Well, the brothers, they looked and they saw, look, there's our brother, and he's got that coat on. Remember, they're still steaming. They're angry about this coat. So they plotted, we're gonna get back at him. Ooh, this is not going well, kids. They come up with a scheme that's not very nice. They decided that when Joseph came up, that they were going to throw him into a hole in the ground. Yeah, this hole in the ground is where they would get water from to give the sheep a drink. But this particular hole had dried up and there was no water in it. So when Joseph came, they ripped off his coat and they threw him in the hole. Oh my goodness. But you know, Joseph, he didn't seem, the Bible doesn't say that he gets scared or he gets angry. The Bible seems to indicate that Joseph trusts God. Well, the story doesn't end there. Along comes a caravan, which is a wagon, full of goods that a trader is taking to another country. That country was far away from where they lived. So they decided to get their brother up out of that hole, and then they were going to sell him off to the traders so that he would now go to another country far away. Wow, that was pretty mean. You know what? They even had to come up with a lie to tell Dad. So they came up with this lie that they found their brother and he had gotten killed by a wild animal. Oh, these brothers were terrible. So, that's what happens. Joseph is sent away to a faraway country. But you know what? God was still with Joseph. No matter what those brothers did, God was with Joseph, and God had a plan for Joseph, and that plan didn't stop. So, you're gonna have to join me every week to find out about the plan, because it's really sweet, just like our hot fudge sundae. But it takes layers and it takes time to build it. So next week you're going to hear what the next step is in Joseph's life. But let's remember, God has a plan for Joseph and God has a plan for you. Let's head over to our worship time. Our worship song this month is Really Awesome Plan. Come on.
He's got a plan. He's got a.
Yes, he do.
He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan. awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know. That's what I know. That's what I know. That's what I know.
Let's go.
I know that I can trust him.
Yeah.
I know that I can trust him.
Yeah.
No matter what the season.
Yeah.
His plans are for a reason.
Yeah.
I know they are good. I know they are best. The reason I know is because he said he's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know. Oh, that's what I know. That's what I know. Oh, that's what I know.
And when I'm feeling so sad, hey, when I am afraid, God will never leave me. No, 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 His love will never change. I know they are good. I know they are bad.
Awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know. Oh, that's what I know. That's what I know. Oh, that's what I know.
Who? Who? You know what time it is?
It's time to hear a story full of wonder. There's so much fun we'll have.
To see what's inside.
Oh, hello there, friends. Welcome to the clubhouse. It's me, Kai. I'm so glad you're all here today. I was just about to do something really fun and exciting. Do you want to help me? Great! I was hoping you'd say that. My mom gave me this big bin of stuff to look through. She said it will help me with my plan for a very special party. An ice cream sundae party. I am so excited. Let's look inside. Whoa! Check out these colorful ice cream bowls. These definitely need to be part of my party plan. Oh yes, spoons. You can't eat an ice cream sundae without spoons. Spoons definitely have to be part of this party plan. And so are these decorations. These streamers are perfect.
Who? Who?
It's Ollie.
Hello, Kai. Who? Who? Planning a party, are you?
Hi, Ollie. I sure am. I'm putting together my plan for the very best ice cream sundae party the clubhouse has ever seen. I'm so excited.
Party planning is fun. It's true. I have a story about a different plan to tell you. Just listen to this story. Just follow me through. Who?
Follow me through, follow me through. Ollie's got a Bible story for me and you.
Oh, hello friends. I'm Casey, and I'm helping out at the Cupcake Food Truck. Happy Ice Cream Sundae Month! And what better thing to go with ice cream than cupcakes! See the little ice cream cones on top? I made them for my friend's ice cream sundae party. He has big plans for his party. That reminds me of today's story. If you're ready, on the count of three, yell, tell me a story. One, two, three, tell me a story. Okay. So today's true story from the Bible is all about a plan. Did you know that God has a plan for you? It's true! God has a plan for us. And he had a plan for Joseph too, like we see in this true story from the Bible. This is Joseph. Hi, Joseph. Joseph had 11 brothers. Let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Whoa! That's a lot of brothers. One day, Joseph's father gave him a special gift. It was a coat! An absolutely beautiful coat. When the brothers saw Joseph had a special coat and they didn't, how do you think they felt? Do you think they felt happy? Show me your happy face. Or do you think they felt mad? Show me your mad face. Which do you think they were? Yes! They were mad that Joseph had a special coat and they didn't. So they took Joseph's coat away and threw him in the ground. That's not good. That would make me sad or mad or even scared. But do you know what? Joseph knew that God loved him, and he knew that God was always with him, so he could trust God's plan. Just then, his brother showed up and pulled Joseph out of the hole. Uh-oh. What are they doing? The brothers sent Joseph with some people going to Egypt, and they took him really, really, really far away. Things were not going well for Joseph, but he knew that God loved him, and he knew that God was always with him, so he could trust God's plan. God loved Joseph and had a plan for him. In fact, there is a lot more of Joseph's story to tell. And God loves us, and he has a plan for us too. Did you like the story? If you did, give it 2 thumbs up. 2 thumbs up. Hey, Ollie, tell me, who has a plan for you?
God has a plan for me. Yes, it's true. Now let's hear it from you. Tell me, who has a plan for you?
God has a plan for me. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. See you next time.
So there's your story. It's all true. God had a plan for Joseph, and he has a plan for you.
Thanks, Ollie.
Goodbye to you. Hoo, hoo.
Wow, what a story. Joseph must have been really scared, but he knew God loved him and was always with him, so he could trust in God's plan. I think I got this story. Did you get it? If you did, say got it. Get it?
Got it!
Good. Well, speaking of plans, I need to get some help planning for this ice cream sundae party. I think I'm gonna get my friends to help me. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye!
You enjoyed that story. Wow, I just love to know that God has a plan for me, and I hope that you love it too, because God has a plan for you. Let's say our key question again. Who has a plan for me? God has a plan for me. That's right. So let's close in prayer, and we'll see you next week. But let's remember today that God has a plan for our life. Will you join me in prayer? Heavenly Father, I thank you that you have a plan for me, that you have a plan for those watching right now, that you are with us, that you never leave us, and you have a plan for our life. And we thank you for that plan. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. I'll see you next Sunday.